Rick, it seemed like Reed Shepard was just kind of having one of those nights that basketball players tend to have sometimes, but a lot of open looks as well. Just kind of how did you assess the three-point defense?
Well, one, they're, I've said it before, they're the most explosive offensive team in the country, and we were getting beat off the ball too much, middle ball screen, what they did we thought would come, and and they made the right play. They're good. And I don't want to take anything away from them. I thought, again, John's teams always get better this time of year, and they're gonna make shots. And I told you, even when you guard them, they make shots. But early in the game, they scored some off of broken plays where I thought they were beating us to 50-50 balls. I told the guys after the game, I thought we were way, way, way too emotional at the start of the game. Didn't execute. Impatient offensively, taking shots at where we could have got more quality shots, and that feeds into them. And you let them get a little separation, they get comfortable. They can start getting out and going with it. And I thought we really did a good job cutting the lead back there, because we weren't very good offensively in the first half. And I thought today's score would, honestly, I thought it'd be a higher scoring game than it was. I really did. I'd expect it to be pretty much what up there, because both teams are going to play fast. But we had too many shots that were not high-quality shots. And it kept almost like we were just hoping we'd make one. But, again, I'm really proud of these guys. They fought hard. They're regular season champions in the best league in the country. And disappointed. But, like I told them, we'll learn from this game, because I hope we're going to be in a lot more bigger games as the season goes on. And we can't let our emotion get the best of us.
I was going to ask, how do you control those emotions when you're entering the postseason?
Well, I mean, a lot of it had to do, you know, we'd already wrapped up the regular season, and then you got seniors that are playing at home, and guys that wanted to, you know, they want to play their hearts out, and they put too much pressure on themselves, you know, thinking, hey, we got to get it done early, and knowing that, again, we have great respect for them and their program and what they do, but we were just too antsy, especially on the offensive end. I mean, we were just, the first half defensively, but because of us playing faster, there's obviously more possessions there. But with that said, you know, free throw line, we should be better. And I think Dalton's got to do a better job of getting his teammates involved when teams are really pressing up on him. But I also think his teammates have got to make some of those open shots for us. And We had looks, we did, but I just thought we just, again, and I don't, again, want to take anything away from Kentucky. I just thought we were way too emotional.
That last possession, y'all had down three, looked like Dalton fell down. I'm assuming y'all wanted to get the ball to him, and were you happy with the shot you got given that?
Yeah, we had, you talking about the one Joe missed?
Yeah.
I mean, it was a wide open shot, and he's made that shot. So, yeah, probably ended up being a better look than what we would have gotten, but didn't go down.
Coach, when you lose a game like that, the guy plays like Dalton did, do you feel like it was just kind of you wasted a performance like that?
No, I don't think that. Again, I told him when I was taking him out, I said, man, you got to get the ball to your teammates some. You know, I said, you got to get them off of you, and the way you do that is let those guys go get easy baskets. No coach is going to sit there and watch guys roll to the basket, get dunks, you know, giving up wide open shots. You might, you know, you're not going to do that. And he's high-level competitor, and he's a guy that, as we know, every shot he shoots, he thinks is going in. I just thought he settled on some of them. But our execution from the beginning of the game, and I thought from that point on we were just clawing our way back in. But these guys keep fighting, and think about it with us. Where we were, we still had a chance there maybe, but didn't get it done.
Rick? As you move forward, how important is it to kind of get Santi going, get him a little more confidence in his shot?
He's got to do it. You know, he's been here. I mean, I wish if I could, I would do it. I mean, he's going to have to do it. He's going to have to trust in himself and believe in how good a player he is, and he's going to have to do it. And again, if I could, I'd have him all, you know, razor sharp every game. But the mental side of it, he's got to do it, and we need him to do it, and. We need everybody, not just Santi. We need everybody doing what they can do. And again, we obviously you got a guy, Dalton, can get 40 points, but I'm telling you, he could have gotten his teammates involved more today, too, and he's got to do that.
What does that look like for Dalton? I mean, just in terms of the ways to get his teammates more involved, the moments.
Well, like on the transition day, he's bringing the ball down the floor, and Joe was to his left wide open. And I asked him, I said, why didn't you pass the ball? He said, I didn't see him because he's so intent, and he's a terrific scorer, and that's what happens when you can score like that. But that's where he's going to continue to get better. I mean, but, again, whether you're in a double team, picking it up, making the play out, all those type things, and he'll, again, he'll continue to get better with it. But I think he's got to get to the line more, and he's got to do a better job at the free throw line. And I know I'm asking a lot from a guy that's, but when we look at it and defensively, you know, they were getting at him pretty good, and he's going to have to continue to do that, play on that end too.
Rick, I'm sure you'd rather win every game, but are you a believer in sometimes guys learn more from a loss than they would a win in some situations? Does it have to be that way?
I'm really hoping this one, we learn from it, because again, I told our guys, I said, if we do what we hope to do, we're going to be in games just like this, and we can't, when the game's over with, look back and say, well, one, we didn't execute the way we're capable of, and why, and knowing that, I mean, we know our team, and we were way out, just way too emotional to start the game, and I said, you don't want to end it on that emotion. You just got to do what we've done, believe in what we've done. Am I surprised? Not really. I mean, we've had a brutal, you know, 3 weeks here, and again, I compliment these guys because what they did, not a lot of teams can do. And again, you're playing against a team that's playing great basketball too. Again, the most explosive offensive team in basketball. And with that said, do I think we can play better today? Yes, I don't think there's any question that we're a lot better than we played today. And really, specifically on the defensive end. And like you said, too many wide open shots, broken plays where they made plays early in the game. I thought three loose balls that we should have come up with, we didn't, and they scored on them.
Yeah, Rick, you touched on this a little bit already, talking about the emotion going in this game. And was that just a unique one-off situation, whether it being senior night, or is it more of a concern given you are going to have more emotional games?
No, you're always concerned on senior night, because you got more people around, you got your families in, and they all seniors want to win. They do, and they want to play well, but, you know, you're always, you know, we've been in such a rhythm, really, you think about it, for 4 or 5 months now. And then all at once, everything changes. And again, it's, you don't make excuses about it, because it is what it is. Every team goes through it. But if you ask me personally, I'd probably do senior night differently, but because it's different. It really is. But every team goes through it. But I don't want to, again, take away, you know, Kentucky did what they had to do. Every time they needed to make a big play, they did. And when we needed to, we got some of them, but not enough.
Rick, this is kind of a knock on wood kind of question, but you just finished a regular season where your top eight players out of 248 games played 247. I think Tobey missed the North Carolina game. How huge was that this year, given that, you know, you haven't always had those type of deals, and you always knew you could count on everybody every game?
We can, and again, I even think we could, again, would be prepared to go deeper. We put Freddie in today because, you know, in the last week he's done some good things, and we put him in to get his feet wet just in case we need him in the second half. If Zakai came out, and, you know, Zakai only playing 8 minutes in the first half, obviously is a purchase, but we wanted Freddie to have a feel. We had, and Zakai picked up an early foul in the second half and had to get somebody out there, and again, I'm proud of our guys. I mean, every one of them has improved. We can get better. We got to get better. But I believe, as a coaching staff, we believe in our depth. And I think any game, you go back through the last six games, certainly the five that we won, there's been a different guy in all five games that made the difference in the game. And that's the kind of team you want to have.
Last three, we're going to go Reese, Al, John.
Coach, you spoke a lot about emotions. What's the best route to kind of contain those emotions, especially because when you get to the NCAA tournament, there's going to be a lot of emotions.
Living it. I mean, that's how you learn from it. I mean, if you, you know, I've always said, you know, I'd much rather, you know, learn something with a win, but sometimes when you lose, and our guys, I think, know it. And again, it's not like, you know, again, I was concerned when we won the regular season championship at my first year at Texas. We clinched it just like this, came home and lost to Missouri. But our team tonight played a lot harder than that team. And this group, they came out wanting to win the game. And again, playing an opponent like Kentucky who was better than that Missouri team at the time. But I did see the emotion. Was it in my mind? It was. But didn't mention it other than the fact that I just wanted us to stay focused and defend. And they're as difficult a team to defend as you're going to guard because they can hit you from all different spots. And again, offensively, we got to be better. Got to be better. Put too much pressure on our defense.
Coach, what kind of problems did Reeves give you tonight?
Well, like he does everybody. You know, he's a high-level scorer. He can give it to you from different levels, and John does a good job getting him in positions to where he can get some things done. And but again, they're surrounded by guys that can play, and they're hard to defend. But I thought again, too many times we did open our hips up and let them get angles on us, which a lot of that has to do. They're talented basketball players; they know how to do that. But again, John does a good job in his schemes, getting those guys in position where they can be effective.
Last one from John.
Rick, you in the back here, you alluded to you like to see senior day done differently. I know some schools have started to do it after the game. What would you like to do differently?
Probably like that because I think these guys deserve more than 2 minutes sometimes. I think they deserve a chance to maybe speak to the fans who they love dearly and let them interact with the fans a little bit more. But that's something that I guess would have to be talked about from a lot of different people. But what Santi and Josiah has meant to our program the last 5 years, I could stay here with you guys all night talking about stories and things they've done behind the scenes and what they do on the floor and in the locker room that they're going to go out as, two of the all-time great balls. And then Dalton coming in, I mean, who could have guessed it or imagined it or guessed that he was going to have the kind of year that he's had. And he's, again, I think it's the first time he's lived it. And learning how to deal with the media that surrounds the SEC and all that, I mean, it's really truly one of the most remarkable years. I've seen one guy come in and do what he's done. But Zakai coming back from a year ago, I'm baffled that he's not on the Koozie Award. I'm shocked because I know maybe he didn't get off to the great start, but that guy, I mean, there's not a coach in the country would not want him to be out there. And so, again, there's just so many positives. And, again, you want to win them all, you do, but as long as we'll learn from it this time of year and know that now it's you either win or you go home.